My name is Gary O'Connor, and I am the media arts instructor at Whitmer High School.
All right, and what inspired you to become a teacher?
Everybody has their own stories of why they wanted to be a teacher, and they always have people that influence them. And for me, I was lucky enough, I had two teachers that influenced me. One was actually my baseball coach when I played baseball in high school. And when you play baseball in high school, you think, I'm going to play forever, I'm going to be a pro, I'm going to go on, I'm going to live a happy life, all this kind of stuff. Mm-hmm. But he helped me to understand that there's life after baseball, and not everybody goes on to play baseball. And when I was in high school, I was a pretty small guy, and still am, but so the idea was I wasn't going to play baseball beyond high school. And so he helped me to understand that there is things, you know, there are things you can do. And so moving to the avenue of coaching and becoming a high school teacher was a way for me to stay involved in baseball and keep my, you know, the skills of helping others to move on in baseball. So that was a big part for me. The other was a teacher I had my junior year in high school. Her name was Jean Taylor. And she was the first teacher that actually, first off, she wouldn't accept my answers of why I couldn't do something. And she's like, you're smarter now, you can do it. And she prodded me to be better. And she made me a better student. She made me a better person. She made me believe in myself as a student. And ultimately, you know, what I have done in my life, I owe a lot to her, because mm-hmm. her belief in me helped me to believe in myself and be able to move forward.
Oh, that's nice. And what was one of the biggest struggles of becoming a teacher?
For me, I wasn't a traditional college student. I knew right away in high school, if you want to go to college, you have to pay for it yourself. Mm-hmm. I was the only one in my family to go to college. Everybody else went into the work industry right away. And so I knew I wanted to go to college. I knew for me to do what I wanted to do, which was coach and stuff like that, I had to go to college. So I worked, and I worked full time. During part of my time, I took time off to be able to join the National Guard. And so I 25 years military experience through them, and it just, I wasn't your traditional live in a dorm, go to class, meet with my friends after school. I had to work. I'd go to class, I'd work, I'd get off 2-3 o'clock in the morning, get up for an 8 o'clock class. And again, when you're paying for your class, getting up for an 8 o'clock class, you know you have to get up for it, because there's, you know, the only person you have to answer to is yourself. Mm-hmm. And when that money's coming out of your pocket, you go to class.
And what about video specifically made you want to teach it?
Video was, in college, for all my electives, I took mm-hmm. classes in photography and stuff like that. So I always had an interest in media. And when I was teaching in the junior high, we actually had the idea of starting a media class. And the principal finally agreed, and we started the media class when I was in the junior high. So it started spreading from just doing pictures and stuff like that to video. We started doing stuff, and I took a room that was over there, and I made it into a small studio. We used old TV monitors or computer monitors with a camera directly above it. Used Excel spreadsheet as our teleprompt, but we started broadcasting. And so the broadcast really spiked my interest, and I kept doing that. My background is in shop. So wood shop, machine shop, architecture, things like that. So the video was such a great opening for me to be able to go, because they had nothing over here. And so after teaching it for several years in the junior high, I moved over to the high school, and they didn't have a video program over here. So I started bugging the principal, hey, we should do a video, we should do video, we should do video. And eventually he succumbed to my wishes, and he let me have a video class. And now that we're part of the career center, it's been a great transition for me. And towards the end of my career, so it's been a great way to end my career working in video. It's just a ton of fun. And it breaks all the norms that I'm used to. Woodworking, drafting, architecture, all have rules, and you got to stay within those rules. Video has no rules. You do whatever you want. And the creativity side of it is something I struggle with, but I love it because it's helping me to expand who I am.
Well, that's great. How do you keep up or adapt to the changing technology within the field and teaching that to kids?
That's tough, because some of the kids will come in and know some things more than I do. And so for me, I don't want to be afraid of that. And that's something I think I'm very good at, is I give kids the opportunity. I've had students that come to my class and they want to learn animation. I know nothing about animation. So I'm like, let's learn. So we work together on it, and we not just I teach them, but they also teach me, so we help each other. And I think that's been something that has been great for me and has been great for my students, because I'm not afraid to try something I don't know. So learning it on YouTube videos, learning it from somebody else, calling people on the phone saying, hey, how do you do this, is something I'm pretty good at, because all they can tell me is, no, I can't help you. Then I call the next person. Hey, how do you do this? And so that helps my students to see that I'm not always the answer, but together we can find an answer. And I think that's a big part of what my class does.
When and what was the most memorable moment in your career?
There's a lot of memorable moments. You know, it's when your students come back to you and when they tell you that you help them to see promise in them, much like Gene Taylor saw in me. You know, it's those types of students. You know, specifically, I don't know if I could actually name a couple, but one in particular was when my son played baseball. I can tell you a moment when there. But we used to do a thing. We used to walk from third base to home, all the seniors with their parents. It was the last walk, we called it. And so coaching, I'm doing it. My son's a senior. And so we're going through everything. And I had set up with my assistant coach that he was going to do, because we had announced their name with the parent and they would walk home. And when it was my turn, I ran over to third base. By the time I got to third base, I was crying, because it was such an impactful moment for me at that point. Mm-hmm. And so, but teaching wise, to me, it truly is. It's the students that come back to me and say, hey, you helped me to see something in me I didn't know I had. And knowing that I've sparked an interest in them, that they've gone on into a career in that, that's really the special moments. Those are the ones, and there's been quite a few, and that's what I look forward to every day.
And thank you for coming out with us today for this interview. I really appreciate your time.
Jack, thank you for interviewing me. I appreciate being here. Love being able to, you know, say what I do here and what we have done to change this program.